And a hit.
12.
Straight yellow to the middle was what he was intending to leave. From there it would have been simple to clear up, or as simple as anything can be at this stage. So now he's got to forget all that and concentrate on engineering another opening.
Well, Eddie Charlton.
Well, that's a fluke. He would almost certainly have left the yellow had it not dropped in. But he's still struggling, having snookered himself on the green. Or can he just hit an edge? Looks as if he can from that angle, but the danger is that he might leave the green over the balk pocket. The alternative might be to come off the balk cushion and hope to put plenty of distance between the cue ball and the green.
Thorburn, 2.
You'll be delighted with that. So, has Eddie Charlton missed his chance? Time to go? No, not quite. And just the last couple of shots, this frame seems to have swung in Thorburn's favour. This frame already in progress, 50 minutes, second longest of the match. Still, quite a few hardy souls here to watch the conclusion of this first round match. Despite the lateness of the hour, 1:15 I make it. Well, is there no justice, he's saying, or words to that effect. So Thorburn, having fluked the yellow, has now fluked the green. Charlton was pretty disappointed that the brown went safe when it might not have done. Good shot, though. Good shot. So, could this produce the frame and match-winning opening? The escape from this snooker is a bit of a hit-and-hope shot as far as where the brown goes. Good hit, and got it safe. Eddie Charlton calling a natural break. Fifty-five. 54 minutes, this frame. And the Australian has just left the arena for a moment or two.
So at this point, and we're after 1 o'clock in the morning virtually now, there was a cup of tea arriving. Was it a cup of tea or was it cocoa? Or it was a cup of something. I don't know about sending people to sleep. It's about keeping them awake, I should think. Of course, this is not the longest Crucible match by any means. When Cliff Thorburn played Terry Griffiths some years ago, was it 83, I think it was? In fact, it was the same match that Cliff Thorburn got that 1-4-7 break in. That ended around 4 o'clock, didn't it, in the morning? So Cliff's used to it, and Eddie is certainly used to it, Steady Eddie. I mean, he's played a few marathon matches in his time. And I suppose Len Ganley, smiling and good-humoured as always, has seen it all before as well. Ah, there's Terry Griffiths on the left there with John Smyth, the referee. Terry Griffiths, of course, another marathon man who takes his time, doesn't believe in hurrying along just for the sake of it. Anyway, the players are back in now. And here we go again. And just a reminder again, if you're joining us, that this is not happening this morning. This was happening, well, it was happening this morning, but very early this morning. And Steady Eddie is back in play.
Another cannily late snooker. Another good hit, and again it's far from easy for Charlton. He didn't have a pot on at all from the last escape. This one isn't easy, but he must go for it, I think. There's a man with a taste for late night snooker, watching it as well as playing it. Griffiths, of course, was here till 20-2 in the morning, beating Eddie Charlton in a memorable semi-final in 1979. And till 9 minutes to 4 in the morning, losing to Cliff Thorburn in the second round in 1983. Beautifully struck, and with blue and pink, Eddie Charlton will be the winner.
Oh, come on.
Four, Eddie Charlton.
Well, how on earth, after such a good brown, could he miss that? And if he doesn't win now, he'll know that's the ball that's cost him the match.
Five.
So now, the pink will give Thorben the frame and pull him up to 8-9. One-minute frame in which Eddie Charlton had a golden chance to clinch the match, but it's Cliff Thorben who wins it to stay in the tournament. One behind, two to play.
Well, at this point, some spectators had the audacity to leave at 1:28 in the morning.
Hey, come back! Hey, come on! Come back! I'll pay you a fiver a fee. Come on!
It wasn't enough, though. I tell you what, though, no one was leaving after the next frame because Cliff won it. And at 2 o'clock in the morning, this marathon match went into the deciding frame. Here it is. It's Cliff trailing 5-8, and it's already now, as we join it, 20 past two, or nearly. Twenty past two in the morning, but no way Terry Griffiths is going home before this match is over. He's not got to play tomorrow. Well, I don't know what Terry Griffiths thought of it, but I know what Eddie Charlton thinks. He thinks he's very unlucky not to have a clear shot at this red over the corner pocket.
rather red near the right corner is potable by striking the cushion first, but it's very risky. The cue ball would be careering into the bunch of reds. This is the better bet.
One.
Played in such a way as to have minimum possibility of leaving anything if he missed it. Well thought out. And now, if he can drill the pink into the balk pocket, or perhaps take it to the middle, he can make a few. He's going to leave that one for a bit.
Seven.
Well, he was going to, until he realised that the pink was going back on the black spot and blocking the black up. Still, if you play long enough, everything happens to you. Well, Eddie Charlton was sure that the cue ball didn't follow a true path. The table ran off in his view. But at this stage, to play a shot that slowly at that distance is asking a lot.
One.
This match already in progress, just over 10 hours. It's more than half an hour a frame.
Eight.
11.
Played to leave himself on the blue. But it's a good angle on the brown and not too bad on the green. Helpful touch off the jaw of the middle pocket. To take a 15-point lead, but disappointed he didn't do better.
One.
Key shot coming up.
Eight.
And with all the reds now in open positions, this is a chance for Eddie Charlton to win the match. Something that he should have done a couple of frames ago when he needed only a simple blue plus pink to follow to win 10-7. So often Eddie Charlton's been disappointed in close finishes on big occasions, including the 1975 World Championship, which he lost by a single frame in Australia to Ray Reardon. But tonight, is it going to be his turn? Should be easy now, but at this stage, nothing is.
Thirty-three.
18 in front. Almost at the winning post. And just black and yellow now, and Thorben will need a snooker.
41.
So, a successful conclusion to the proceedings in sight for Eddie Charlton. It must have crossed his mind that he'd thrown it away a couple of frames ago. But now he's 28 in front, and surely into the second round.
46.
31 the lead, only 22 on the table, and surely it can't slip away now. It's a big win for Eddie Charlton, this. It's a long time since he's beaten anybody ranked as high as sixth in the world. Disappointing for Thorben. He gave it his all. Struggle between two old adversaries finishes at 20 to 3 in the morning. Eddie Charlton beats Cliff Thorben by 10 frames to 9.
And those 10 and a half hours of snooker there for those 19 frames, and Eddie Charlton goes through to meet Tony Mio in the second round. Now, at the press conference afterwards, Eddie was asked about slow play, but he was not apologetic about it at all. I'm a professional snooker player, he said, and I play to win. That's my main consideration. Win, he did. Who'll win today, I wonder? These are the matches to come.
23, 24.
It looks as though he has one for the center pocket.
Yes, and this is just the start Willie required, being the one frame down. Now 50 points in front.
36, 37.
Well, that's the ball he's been looking for. Paddy Brown 55. Now wanting snookers. Nine points ahead with only 67 points there. A nice 55 by Willie there. He'd be very satisfied with the first frame.
Yes, and he went on to pick up most of the rest of the balls as well to win that frame very easily, and what a fluent player he is when he's in that sort of form. So, 5-all, and he's pulled out a lead, 22-21 rather, in the next frame, but that's, of course, Paddy Brown.
1. And he's opened up the reds.
7.
He's certainly got a couple of options here, but they could have brought an easier, better for him.
Yes, he's just that little awkward there, John, isn't he? Willie Thorne, of course, is such a talented player, and yet he's never got beyond the quarterfinals in this World Championship.
8.
And another good recovery shot from Willie. And now looks to have the perfect angle to come down for these reds into this left-hand corner pocket.
Thank you. 70.
Just over hit it again, so still has the 1-2 right in the corner.
18.
You won't be too happy about that one. Great break builder is Willie, known as Mr. Maximum.
Of course, Ted, one of these players that makes the game